And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Robert Kelly.
Favorite Beastie Boys song. No credit. Me and Lou were talking about this. This album gets no credit whatsoever. What's up, everybody? It's The Bonfire. Big J. Okerson, Robert Kelly, Sirius XM. It's Monday. It's fun day. I got some good news and I got some bad news. What do you want first? What do you want first, Lou?
Give me the good.
The good news. We got a very special guest. Aaron Berg is in the house.
Yeah. Ooh. That good news gets his day started.
We got two bald bastards in the house.
Looking good, cheekbones exposed, feeling happy, light and lean, squatting our wives.
Just two... What are we doing to our wives?
Squatting.
What does that mean?
I'm strong enough now that I'm in good enough shape. I can pick my wife up and squat her.
Well, I don't know if I'm there yet.
All right.
If I can squat her.
You can give it a go?
I can give it a go.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's light. She's got no butt.
God, you look good. You got veins coming back in your neck and stuff.
Is that a good thing? I don't know. Is that a good thing?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, really?
Vascularity's king.
Vascularity. I like that word. I got veiny neck.
Yeah, you got veiny neck.
I got veiny neck, baby.
You're going to have upper pecs popping out of that shirt soon.
Ooh, look at it. I think they're coming out.
I do. I see them.
You see them?
Yeah, you're nice. A good-looking man again.
Nice. Yeah, if I take my shirt off, though, I look melted, but it's okay.
Yeah. Little candle action.
No, it's actually not as bad. I'm very excited. It's not...
Welcome to Shade 45.
It's not as bad as I thought. It's not as bad. Like, I thought I was going to look like, you know, a pregnant woman.
Yeah.
After birth. But no stretch marks, no gooiness yet.
Not looking like a Dodge Charger with flames down the side?
No, yeah.
It's good.
Yeah, like the car from Grease Lightning?
Yeah.
No, not at all. We got bad news, too. Sorry, we got the good news.
Good news was
good. You're here, which I'm excited about.
Me, too.
And we got some bad news. Lou, you want to tell people the bad news? You want me to break it to them?
You break it.
I'll break it. We got more good news, though. You want no more good news?
No, I want the bad.
That's terrible. Big J is not here right now. I mean, it's sad. It's sad. Everybody just shut their radios off. Turn them back on. He's coming. His plane has landed. He's on the BERT tour and... his plane got canceled this morning. Delta canceled. And then JetBlue delayed. I called the poor guy. He had no lounge life.
Why?
Because his Delta flight got canceled.
Oh, yeah. You get JetBlue has no lounge. You're out of luck.
You have nothing.
You'd rather stay with Delta and come in a day late so you could have the lounge all day.
But he wanted to get back to the show. So what did he do? He made sure he got on the next flight out. And he sacrificed for all the campers. Crackle.
Yeah.
Right?
Crackle.
I was waiting for a sound effect from Lou, like a little
crackle.
I got nothing. He only works for Jay. He only works for Jay. But he's on the plane, and I got word his plane just landed.
Yeah, you talked to somebody high up.
I talked to Jay, actually. I talked to Jay, and his plane just landed. Why don't we get a, what do we call him, Lou? Call him and get a little update, see where he's at. What
okay,
do you think?
Here's his number, 212.
No, it's 917. It's actually 917. Let's give his number out. You guys call him. Fuck that. You call him. Yeah. It's 917. Hang on, I got it right here. Ready? Let's call, get a little Big J update. He's on his way to the studio. His plane has landed.
Hello?
Big J, how are you, buddy? We're in the studio. I'm here with Aaron Berg, and we're just trying to get a Big J update. We heard that you landed. Your plane landed. You're in JFK.
Nope. I'm still on the plane.
You're on the plane?
Yes. It just let everybody stand up just now. It's been such an adventure.
Oh, no.
It's,
Can you tell them to shut up while we're talking, please?
Tell me on the radio.
I would shut up.
So you're going to be here, what, 20 minutes?
Oh, you know what? Leave the light on and leave the door open, because I am.
Okay.
I'm going to try to get out of here without yelling at people or making a pissy face.
All right, well,
you got me again. Do me a favor. Could you and Aaron please run down JetBlue today?
Yeah, sure. Absolutely. We'll talk crap about JetBlue.
Wow.
If it was Delta, I'd have to say no. Because I'm
Spirit for white people.
Right, Jesus Christ.
Yeah. Thank you, Aaron. Thank you.
JetBlue, got somewhere to be? Tough cookies.
Hey, JetBlue, we have mediocre-looking flight attendants.
JetBlue, want to go to a lounge? Too bad for you, JetBlue.
True
no
that.
Lounges.
Nothing nice to look at there.
No.
JetBlue, I mean, they don't even have snacks. They don't have breakfast. They have little crappy snacks, yeah. Jay.
JetBlue, we
I'll
spit
tell you,
on
I'll
Pride
tell you what
Month.
They have. I'll tell you what they do have. Only 3-seat rows.
Mm.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, that's bad for an ex-fat guy.
Yeah, but you get that little baby TV. That's good, right?
No. Okay, you know what? Don't say anything to JetBlue, but yes.
It is good. It's better than flying United and just staring at a gray piece of leather for 3 hours.
Yeah. Direct TV he's got.
I hope on the next update I'm still sitting here.
All right. Well, we're going to call you back in a few minutes, maybe 20 minutes. You should be in the car headed back, right?
Let's hope.
All right, Jay. Well, we love you, and we'll see you in the studio very shortly.
Too.
All right?
Yes. You guys have a good show.
All right,
thanks, Jay.
Be safe out there. We'll see you soon.
Yes, I'll be on.
Here's an airplane going by.
Jacob, relax. Come on. Settle down.
Hashtag tarmac life, bro.
Jacob's here, too. Hi, Jacob. How are you, buddy?
I'm good, Bobby.
I'm good. I can't hear you.
Hey.
Don't yell at anybody, Jacob.
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing fantastic. I sent Jacob, you know, last week I was driving home from the bonfire and I saw a UFO on the Hudson.
I saw a UFO last week as well.
Where?
In New Jersey.
Where?
In my town, driving on the main road to go to my street.
Yeah.
I saw a green light just zing through the air and then it was gone. It was not a plane. There's no way it was a plane.
I have photo evidence and they keep calling it a bird.
Show me the photo.
I don't have it.
That's what evidence means, is you have
I
it.
I have it, but I don't have it right now. Yes.
I saw a green light just zing across. It looked identical to the green light that the Spanish people saw. Remember the cops
si,
all showed up?
See.
Si.
See.
Si.
See.
Si. See. Si. Esta una verde light. That's what they yelled. Yeah, there was a green light.
Si,
I saw
amigo.
It. I believe in it now. Now that they did a conference.
There it is, right there. Look at it. See it? Right there. Everybody, we're looking at my photo from last week. It's on somewhere on the internet, right?
It's on Twitter. I'll retweet it.
It's on Twitter right now. We're going to retweet it so you can look at it. And zoom in if you could, Christine. Christine, thank you so much, Christine. You're the best, Christine. When was the last time somebody told you that? You're the best.
Just you.
Well, it's not a bird.
I mean, Christine, can you zoom in, Christine?
I am zoomed in. It's
don't get
dog.
Mad at me. I'm not Jay. Please don't take it out at me.
Look,
I love you. I just said you're doing great.
I mean, she zooms in then back out.
I mean, she's never talked to Jay like that.
No.
Christine, enhance that section, please.
Thank
I'm
you.
I'm trying,
thank
and
you,
it
Jacob.
Keeps going in and out.
Well,
yeah.
I mean, that's
yeah, that's how it goes.
That's how it goes. So anyways, I was driving and I took it, and it was a flying something.
Yeah.
Something that was cruising.
What day was it?
It was on
June 14th.
I think it was.
It might have been the 13th.
Mine was June 14th too. I'll just say that. That's a Bob Kelly fact.
Yours was June 14th.
Yes.
Mine, I'm going to tell you now.
Mine was June 14th. I wasn't lying.
Therapy, money. Yep. It was that night.
June 14th.
Yeah, driving home.
There's a UFO going around and nobody believes me, and I have photo evidence, and they say it's a bird. Birds have to flap their wings.
Yeah.
That is not a bird. There it is, right there. Look. Look. Look, right there. See it? Look at that. That is not a bird.
Oh, that's a bird.
That's how can you do that?
There's wings.
No, there's not a wing,
no,
dude.
No, that's not wings. Okay. I believe it. I believe they're real now.
I mean, it's happening. It's happening.
Here's my problem with these aliens.
Now, okay, that image.
Yeah.
It did not move from, it stayed that image. Like, it didn't flap a wing. It didn't go caw. It didn't make any noises. It was that thing the whole time.
Was it moving?
Moving.
Yeah, it's a UFO, dude.
It's a UFO.
Yeah.
They're here, and I discovered them.
I saw it. It was a green light. This is how long I saw it for. One, two, gone. Yeah. Not a plane, and I know there's a lot of small planes in my neighborhood. Not a plane.
What are you going to do when they come down? Are you going to go meet them, or are you going to run away?
Here's my problem with them.
You already have a problem with them?
Yes, I do.
You do?
Yeah.
You don't like aliens?
First of all,
you want to build that wall?
I'm a legal immigrant. I paid money to get into this country.
Because you're from Canada.
It cost 30 grand. Yeah. It took me like 10 years to get into this country.
As it should, because Canadians, it should take longer.
That's not it. I'm not opposed to illegal immigrants, especially when they're coming from space. There's no border patrol in space. My problem is...
We do.
No.
Superman.
Not real.
Thor.
Not real.
Dude, there's a lot.
These are movies. These aren't real things.
Yeah, you think they are, but where do they get the idea from them?
I'm not buying it.
Okay, whatever. We'll see.
Here's my problem with these aliens.
Yes.
It's not that they're not coming to take jobs. They're not doing anything like that.
What aliens are we talking about?
These aliens in space.
The space aliens.
Space aliens.
What about the land ones?
I'm fine with them.
Yes, I love them. I love them.
I'm considering hiring live-in help. I'm fine.
Dude, I say open the borders.
They do really good work. They fix my driveway.
They're the best.
Yeah.
It's not like we're letting a bunch of rude jerks in. They're nice, awesome people that help. I mean, I love them.
Yeah.
Let them in.
That's what I say. But not these aliens.
You don't want the space.
Do you know
ones.
Why?
Why? Because they're
How
green.
Tall am I, Bobby?
Oh, no.
How tall am I?
You're 4'2".
No.
I'm sorry. How tall are you? All right, 5'8".
No.
How tall? Oh, geez, you're shorter than that.
Split the difference.
Okay, you're 5'1".
I would say realistically, I say I'm 5'6". I may be 5'5".
Holy shit.
These aliens are...
My wife is taller than you.
What a weak pimp.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. What the fuck? You have to lift weights.
I have to lift weights.
You have to create an illusion.
It's not easy being short.
Yeah, man.
Here's the problem.
I don't even know if that's short. That's
you know how tall those aliens were that they found in wherever it was, New Mexico?
I do not.
They're 8.5, 9 feet tall.
Yeah.
They're too tall. I don't need more tall people.
Not too tall. If we get them to play for us on the Olympics, that'd be good. Like on the basketball team, that'd be nice.
How long until the aliens are like, we're all trans? That'd be awesome.
The end of the summer?
Really?
I don't know, dude.
I'm worried that they're that tall. That's what upsets me, is the height of these things.
Yeah, but you should be afraid of everybody.
Why?
Because we're all taller than you.
Not at carnivals.
You're 5'6", dude. I didn't know that. Do you have to wear like high heel pumps or something?
No.
Do you wear like a lift?
No.
Do you have boots on right now?
I'm wearing these nice new shoes. They're very comfortable. They're lifting shoes.
That's a lifting shoe?
Yeah, it's a lifting shoe.
That's embarrassing, dude. good on you, admitting it.
Thanks.
On a radio show.
Yeah.
You wear a lift shoe, so it pumps you up.
To lift weights. They're weightlifting shoes. Not lift shoes. I wouldn't wear lifts.
You guys, I made the mistake. I thought...
I'm fine with my own height. I've dealt with it for years and years, and I feel very comfortable being short. And I overcompensate in many other ways.
You do.
But I feel good about that overcompensation.
So your problem with the aliens is that they're tall.
Yeah.
But can I say something? E.T., your height.
Wasn't a real alien. Movie.
Yeah, but you don't know that.
You think E.T.'s real?
What do you think they're going to...
E.T. would be the weakest of those aliens. They eat aliens like E.T. Uh-huh. That's what they would do. They would skewer them for 4th of July.
So you think the aliens are coming down, they're going to be 9 feet tall?
Yes.
And they're going to be alpha?
They are. And people are saying they're going to be nice aliens.
Yeah.
I think that's only a matter of time until one of them gets pulled over by a dirty cop in Minneapolis. Then they're all going to turn.
I don't understand. I don't know what you're doing.
You don't think...
What are you, back on the Kumia Network? What's happening right now?
God forbid.
I don't understand what's going on.
I think cops are going to be violent towards aliens.
Why?
Come on. Cops look at the track record.
Listen, dude. Cops are kind of got their shit on pause right now.
Yeah.
Like, all those cops kind of retired, and now cops are... If you walked around New York City, they look like future cops. They look like... Demolition Man cops now.
Cops in New York City only start at $44,000 a year to work in New York City. Do you know how difficult that is?
I don't.
Cops in my town make $85,000 a year, and they just sit in their car. That's it. Cops really? Here are getting stabbed with needles, making $44,000 a year. Wow. It's crazy.
Are you running for office? I don't understand. I'm having a fun alien talk with you, and all of a sudden you're giving me stats like Gavin McGinnis. What the fuck?
Jesus
what
Christ. Dude,
you know what cops make? 44% of cops in Manhattan would kill an alien. Right? Yeah.
Cops are going to turn on aliens? Cops have been waiting for this moment for aliens to get here. All the movies you love, when the aliens arrive, and as soon as they find out these are bad, everybody's in line to take a pot shot at an alien.
Dude, I don't think so. I think the aliens have been here for
and
a while.
Don't you ever compare me to Gavin McInnes again.
I'm sorry, I apologize.
I did find Vice Magazine, however.
Dude, I'm just saying that I don't think that the aliens are going to come down and be jerks.
I hope they're nice.
I think they've already been here.
You think?
Yes.
Yeah.
I think Lou is an alien.
Impossible.
Dude, have you ever seen how fast he is on that board?
His eyes do look like he's from Futurama or something.
Dude, watch when he blinks, it's sideways. Watch.
That's crazy.
Dude, there's nobody faster on a board. You have to have alien blood in you. Look at that. Who brings that up quick? That's his national anthem.
He missed four sound cues in the first 3 minutes for you.
That's because he's trying to pretend like he's not an alien.
Oh, this is how they assimilate.
They assimilate. He's got to pretend like he's human. Listen to that. Good, sing it. That's his national anthem. Sing the song.
Oh.
You got to stand up. Put your hand over your heart. This is the good part. That's a good part.
They're going to play this at hockey games. They're going to be nice. Something's going to turn them. We're a very bad species of people.
I don't think we're that bad.
Look at what we've done to this earth. That's why they're here.
What did we do to the earth except make fun shit?
Why is Greta Thunberg so upset?
She's autistic. That's why. Somebody touched her ears before she went out there. I mean, fuck, dude.
How dare you?
Yeah, dude. We've made this planet awesome.
Come on.
Dude,
compare it to what they've done. When they have a spaceship that looks that big to you, but then all of a sudden you go into it and it's the size of 6 football fields, which is what I've heard. They're way ahead of us. It's like these are portals. That's not even a spaceship. That's a portal.
That thing I saw on the West Side Highway is a portal.
Yeah, it's a portal.
It's not a portal. Let me tell you something. I don't know what you're talking about right now, but I'm going to say this.
Because you're not following. You're using your human brain.
I think Lou is controlling me right now.
Yeah.
I think...
National anthem's catchy.
If you look down, if you come from another planet, right? Because you know their planet is probably, they don't do anything bad. They don't swear. They're, evolved. It's boring. You come down here to New York City on a Saturday night... Do you know how much they're like, what's a fucking donut?
That's what they go for is a donut, not the coke, not the horse.
Yeah, but they go to that. Then they play chess in the park. Then they go to a rave. Yeah. Then they go to a comedy club. Then they go to Jersey. Yeah. They go to an amusement park. We have the shore.
It does feel like you're writing a movie right now.
We have so many fun
things.
This
is called Aliens in New York, written by Bobby Kelly. They're like, we just went and saw, what's the name of the very popular musical everyone goes to see?
Lion King.
And Lion King. King would be good. I was thinking of the other one, Hamilton.
Yeah, dude. I think if aliens came down, right, and they cruise around for, they would be like, this planet is the shit. These people have done it. They made it fun.
I don't think they think that.
Do you like Star Trek or anything like that?
I've watched Star Trek like 5 times over. That's the original series.
So you love it. So don't you think the alien planets are boring as shit? It's just a house with a ruby on it. It stinks. Come into my house and it's just, oh, fucking carved out in the wall, and they got a ruby and some stupid little thing in the middle. And,
yeah.
Oh, they eat like gruel. Dude, we have pancakes.
Yeah, but the gruel's healthy. They're like, this is all the nutrients we require on our planet.
Yeah.
Why are you eating chocolate chip pancakes with so much syrup from a tree?
We drink our food. Forget that.
We reproduce with our eyes.
I know. Remember in Demolition Man when she put the headset on?
Yeah.
And she was like, this is how we have sex?
Yeah.
I want that.
You want that?
I have that now with
my
wife.
It's pretty close. I think Norton does it with his VR glasses.
I do VR too, VR porn.
What's that like?
VR porn you should stay away from.
Why?
What happened with me, and it's different because I was there. There was me, and then there was a girl waitress. I put it on, and I started like talking to the girl, and I started like moving in my chair because we were kind of doing it, and I was going along with it. And she was like, "Hey, baby." I was like, "What?" I started talking to her.
Come on.
It was weird because she's right in your face.
Yeah.
And then the girl put the headset on, and she was looking around, going, "Oh my God, I love those cabinets. That's such a nice kitchen." It was like, ugh. You know, she was looking around the room.
Yeah.
At the accoutrements and the, you know, the cabinetry.
Yeah.
Yeah, she was like, yeah, it was like stupid. So I had to stop though. I brought it on the row with me and I was just sitting on the couch. I was fishing. I fished for like 2 hours.
Oh, I'd like to do that.
Because you can just sit there and fish in your living room and drink and your hand comes up and everything. And then I watch porn.
Yeah.
And they have all kinds of porn. You can type in anything you want.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's pretty, if someone walked in, it was looked like I was singing, oh.
you were blowing somebody. You could have just gone with straight porn.
Yeah. I did that too.
Oh, wow. Yeah, they're real for sure because they were making movies and TV shows about aliens years ago, and now we know it's real.
Jacob, Star Trek. Jacob's in the house in Florida.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'm sad that you're not here, but, you know, it's okay. You're in Florida. You love it down there.
Back soon.
But
in Star Trek, sometimes there's like just a whore island. They go there, and it's just the whole planet is designed that. It's like a VR planet. If you think of something, it comes true.
Yeah, we have that too. Staten Island, Whore Island.
Yeah.
We have the same thing. Lake Havasu, Slutbag Island.
East Hampton.
Yeah. That's what we should have.
Most of the planets sucks. Like, you didn't want to go, but some of them were just party planets on Star Trek.
Really? I don't remember the party planets. I remember them going to a planet that was just a rock, some stupid rock they hid behind.
They'd fight a lot when they got there.
Yeah, there was some plant that looked stupid.
No, there's this episode called Shore Leave.
Yeah.
Where they go down to this beautiful planet, but nobody's there. But every time they have a thought, it just comes true. So one guy just dreams of the hottest chick he never got to bang, and she's just there.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, and it ends up they just get it on. At the end, they realize what's going on, and they party for the weekend.
If the fans of the show were on that planet right now, Jay would appear on the show.
Wow.
Yeah.
We got a great game we're going to play with Jay, by the way.
What is it?
I'll tell you in a few minutes. Okay. Let's finish this alien stuff first, because I think if you look back at Star Trek, we're beyond Star Trek.
Yeah.
I mean, they had a flip phone with no screen, just audio.
Yeah.
What was the sound? Mm-hmm. That's what it made. They had one ring.
Yeah.
I have 5,000 rings on my phone.
At least.
Now. We go like this. That's all they had. So you didn't know. Was that you? So you're out there. You're what is it called, Jacob?
The communicator.
Your communicator, which is a dumb name.
Yeah.
They didn't even name it cool. It's the communicator, and everybody's communicator went.
Yeah. Who's ringing? I don't. Who is that?
Yeah, nobody knows.
Could be everybody now.
Yeah, nobody knows. Yeah. that. Stupid.
Why is it spelled with a K? It's Russian propaganda.
There he is.
Have you tried communicator telephone? You will very much enjoy.
It sounds like somebody killed a bird.
Yeah.
Doesn't it?
Yeah.
Sounds like somebody just stepped on a bird.
Yeah, they shot that bird out of the sky that you saw on the Hudson.
It's not a bird. It was a craft.
Yeah.
And you saw it too.
I saw it. I don't know if I saw the same one as you. There's more than one.
I wish I was on that island right now. You'd have boobs.
Yeah.
You'd have three tits, like Total Recall.
Yeah.
Hottest scene in any movie, by the way.
What would you do with three tits?
Oh, a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, is it the hottest scene in any movie?
What about Bo Derek in 10?
Oh, flattest bum. Here's a problem with 10. I know Bo Derek. I'm friends with her husband.
Come on.
I really am.
Jim Derek.
No, it's not Jim Derek, you ass. Jim Derek. No. Oh, look at that. Total Recall, three boobs.
Yeah.
I mean, three perfect 19.
Perfect? Is that what you're calling those?
Those are perfect.
One of them's got cancer.
Yeah, but the best part is you still got two left. Hopefully it's the middle one. Dude, I love those.
Oh boy.
I mean that scene comes up, I immediately pause just to look at them.
That's what fake boobs are supposed to look like. The perkiness of the nipple, the nipple's in the middle, it's standing upright, the boobs are big and full.
Could you ever get three boobs? Has that ever been done?
It'll happen.
Like after that movie, do you think there's just some hooker who's like, "You know what? I can make more money if I had three tits."
I'm shocked no one's done that.
I think so.
That's the best idea you've ever had.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Better than the flanker?
What's the flanker?
It's a float anchor. I'll tell you about it some other day.
Okay.
I have it in patent right now.
Three boobs is great.
Three boobs is great. Anyways.
They're real. They're here. They're going to be peaceful, but something bad's going to happen.
They're real. They're here. Speak about that. You see this weekend, that Bud Light went full, just said, fuck it.
Came back.
They said, fuck. Oh, they did do it. Yeah. Someone did do it. There you go.
Nice.
Look at that.
20 grand to get a third breast in order to follow her dream of getting her own MTV show, which I'm guessing didn't happen.
No, she wanted to be a celebrity and nobody's ever heard of her. This is from 2014.
Meet the three boobed woman. What's her name?
Let's see.
She's from Florida.
There's a video. Show the video. There you go. Of course she's from Florida. Look at that.
Ew.
Why is that? Ooh, that's so sexy.
It's not sexy.
Christine's jealous.
You're jealous.
Christine's jealous.
I'm jealous of three boobs.
Christine's jealous of one of those boobs.
Look at this poor girl had to know a guy at her strip club that's like, I do bikini tops. I can make you one for three boobs.
Yeah. She has to go to Chris Angel's wardrobe lady. Can you make all my clothes for me?
Look at it. Good for her.
Yeah.
Good for her.
I mean, that's pretty wild.
She looks like a radio fan. I bet she'd be on this show.
We should get her on the show.
Get her on the show.
How long ago? That was probably years ago.
Like one of the boobs just...
I wonder if it's actually real.
She had to get him taken out.
Yeah, something went wrong with him.
Now she has three saggy boobs.
Yeah.
Oh, look at her. That's just so sexy. She's making love to the camera.
She's like a good-looking chick, too. That's
yeah.
Pretty hot.
Lower body's kind of whack.
Does it say her name?
I'm trying to find it.
I bet it. I bet her name is Megan. It has to be a Megan. That's a slut name, isn't it?
Why'd she have to be a slut just because
she has three boobs?
That doesn't mean she's a slut.
What does it mean,
What
Aaron?
If she's a good Christian a girl that's saving
thank you,
until
thank
she gets
you,
married?
Thank you, Jacob. You're right. She's a pig. She's a pig. Dude, why would you need three boobs?
There's
for
her
what?
Name. It's at the top. Something Tridevelle. Said her extra breast felt like her other breast. The only difference is the nipple, which she had to get tattooed on.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's freaky.
There's no milk coming out of that boob.
You couldn't get like a dead old woman's nipple?
Jasmine.
Jasmine. There you go.
There
slut
you go.
Name.
Think she was a stripper?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's for work.
Oh my God, that girl has three tits, bro. Yeah. Everybody would go crazy.
Has there ever been a guy with, you can't get two dicks, right?
No. I got two balls.
I have two balls.
Nice.
Yeah.
You had it done as well.
I got nice balls.
Aaron.
Yeah.
The Titanic's fourth tunnel, the smokestack was just cosmetic. So one of her boobs being cosmetic is...
He's obsessed with the Titanic.
It doesn't matter.
You should go on a sub and go visit it.
No, don't say that. That's mean. Don't do that, Jacob. Jacob, don't do that. It's not safe, Jacob.
Why? A lot of people go and do that now. It's a hot thing to do.
Well, not now. Yeah. I think there's a stop. There's a pause on that.
There's a temporary pause on that?
I think there's a temporary pause on that. I think they can come up with new rules and regulations.
Yeah.
They're not going to let a guy with a Dixie cup and a fucking piece of glass go down and see the Titanic. Oh, it's so sad.
It is sad. It's not as sad as the Chilean miner thing. The Chilean miner thing was sadder.
But they got out.
Yeah. But it was sad that they were trapped. Dude, everybody got behind it.
Yeah, but they were trapped and then they got out.
All of them?
Most of them.
Yeah, a good number of them.
A good number of them did, and then the kids got out. I mean, this.
No one got out. Well, we don't know yet. Fingers crossed.
No, fingers are crossed and mushed together. Yeah, they're very crossed.
Do you think it was hard to breathe there at the end?
No, I actually watched a video of what happened. Jacob, did you see that?
I watched every video.
It's in seconds. It just and what happens? What happened to me? What happened to City Brady?
Pride Month.
One thousandth.
Bud Light. Mythbusters.
Yeah.
Did a thing where the body just explodes inside too. Yeah.
Yeah.
So you just become part of the glass.
Yeah.
It's over within seconds. So
and then that thing blows up.
They didn't even know what happened. So God bless that. They didn't know what happened. They were just down there and they were like, yo, dude, what's going on? He goes, oh, fuck.
That's it.
That's it. Right, Jacob?
From what they're saying, they actually knew it was about to happen.
Oh, God.
Jacob, you're such a downer.
God.
Jacob's such a Debbie Downer.
But when it happened in 1/1000th of a second. And so the human brain doesn't even have time to be scared.
I can do it. I can do it. Ready? I'll do it right now. Ready?
Yeah.
Ready?
Go.
That was it.
Watch this. Nope. I didn't even get to say now.
What?
That's how fast it was. Nope.
Hey, I think the summit is gone.
Yeah. Hey. I'm good. What if one of them yelled, I'm good, and then looked around the other ones were all just salt and pepper on the floor.
The whole thing
that's
just
sad.
Imploded.
It's not as sad as the Chilean thing, because the Chilean thing, these people were working. These people were just like, hey, let's flaunt our wealth and go down.
100% not. They're working.
They were working.
They're trying to get down to the submarine. They're trying to get down to the Titanic. They're doing something that's never been done.
Dying near it?
No, that's been done. I mean, that's never been done. I mean, we do have. I wonder if they're going to put if in the Titanic Las Vegas Museum, if they're going to put something like you can go on that thing now. You know what I mean?
That'd be really macabre.
Submersible?
Yeah, like remake the submersible so you could kind of climb in and see what they were in. Is that bad? Is it too soon?
Yeah, it's too soon.
Too soon. Sorry,
it's
Lou.
Hacky.
Too soon. Too soon.
It's too soon. Do you think that while they were near the Titanic, they were quoting lines from the movie? Like, paint me like your French girls. Like, stuff like that.
Never let go. The fact is they got all the way down. They were, like, inches away from it. They were an hour and 45 down. They were right there.
I'm glad I didn't go.
Well, they knew about it. The Navy knew that it blew up the day they went down. As soon as it happened, they were like, hey, dude, I just heard something.
Really?
What'd it sound like? I don't know, a sub imploding? And then they lied to us for 4 days.
They lied to us.
They lied to us for 4 days.
Wow.
To keep us, you know, the breath and they have this amount of air left and... They kept us going, but they knew right away.
Oh, that's not good.
Yeah, they knew right away.
They should have told us the truth.
Well, Biden's son, man.
Yeah. But then...
Biden's son,
then
dude.
The guys...
Dude, they wanted to distract us, man.
Oh, yeah.
Dude,
it's the
they
whole
wanted
conspiracy
to distract
thing.
Us, man. That's when they found out about the computer, man. And then, yo, man. And then they had the sub, and they're like, yo, pause. Hang on. Everybody did. All right, well, since they're already dead, man, let's say they got some air left.
Oh, they ran it out for another 4 days so that all this stuff could happen.
Yeah,
the plea
man.
Deal with Hunter.
Yeah, man.
And the thing with DeSantis.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we were distracted, dude. Yeah. They were
snapping.
Down there.
Do some more snapping.
Yeah. They were in the sub and they were dead, man.
Oh, government. The government to hurt us.
Man.
The government to distract us.
Yeah.
The government to play like this was a democracy. But I see there is no democracy. See? Mm. It's all a lie. It started with the sub. Spell it backwards. What do you get? Bus. What do you think of when you think of bus? Rosa Parks. We need to emancipate and free everybody to promote equality. Titanic hit the iceberg. Berg, my last name, a Jew. The Jews run all the media, hence hitherto drowning. Who else cannot swim? I won't even say it because I will be canceled.
And I'll get fired, and I like this job. Canceled. So read the subtext. Yeah. Oh. Welcome to the bonfire, everybody.
I've been the wonderful Miss Maisel.
Isn't that what I learned to type on? What are we talking about?
Yes. Maisel.
Well, it's sad that that happened. But, you know, it was a good thing. Do you know that it's Men's Mental Health Awareness Month?
Durf.
What? That's a thing?
Yeah, well, yeah, feminist, Christine.
No, it's not. Not in June.
Look it up.
I'm sorry. You can't have that the same month as Pride Month.
This is a problem.
I'm not taking away anything. I love my gay brothers and sisters. I refuse to be part of Men's Mental Health Month.
It's Men's Mental Health Month, and nobody cares about us.
Why would they?
Why? They should.
Why?
What?
That's crazy.
It's, yeah, nobody cares about it. They gave Men's Mental Health Month to gay people.
Oh, in the United Kingdom.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
No,
yeah,
in the United Kingdom, it's in November.
Where are we originally from, Christine?
No, nobody
where?
Cares.
Where?
England. Africa.
Yeah, Africa. Right. Yeah. Well, you have a point, too.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm a Californian, so Mexico. Yeah.
You have a point.
Men's mental, how's your mental health doing? Pretty good, I would imagine.
It's doing good right now. I had a great weekend with the fam, with the kid. You know, I took Max. I had four shows at the Cellar Saturday night.
Yeah.
And Max is like, Dad, let me come. And I'm so, when you do shows, I have anxiety. People think that we just do shows.
No, we have anxiety before the show, yeah, all the time.
And it's like we learn to deal with it. Like what we're about to do is not an easy thing. We just make it look like it's easy,
yeah,
you know? But we're thinking about it. And especially when you do shows in the city, because you're following, you don't know where you're going up. You got to go up after people that are murdering, after people that maybe didn't do too good, who the host is, where it is, blah, blah, blah. So I have all this anxiety that I've learned to compartmentalize.
And you deal with it in a different way. You'll talk to people. You'll joke around. You'll maybe eat. You'll smoke. And you don't look anxious, but underneath it, you're
and
very
then
anxious.
When you add my wife or my family, now that's a different Bobby. That's protective Bob. That's, I got to make sure you're all right. I'm looking out for you. I want to make sure, you know what I mean? So I get a little crazy, but I'm like, you know, Max is older now. He's kind of cool to hang out with. So at the last minute, I was like, get your stuff. Let's go.
Yeah.
And he went, changed, came out looking rocking.
Blanket, suitcase, chessboard, all of his stuff.
No. He came out looking good. Had a cool hat on, cool shirt. He looked good, which I was like, that made me happy.
Yeah.
He went in, picked an outfit that I can respect.
Rich,
you know,
Voss,
I mean?
Shirt?
No, are you out of your mind? Respect. And we jumped in the car, brought him down there. I mean, I had the best night with him.
Really?
He after the show, he goes, Dad, a lot of that stuff was inappropriate. And I was like, listen, I told you, you can't, this is all jokes. Everything I say about mom, you, whatever.
Oh, he'd never seen before?
No, he's seen me, but last time he saw me, he caught a little upset because I did a joke about him.
Why would you do that?
Because I got to pay the bills.
Yeah, you wouldn't just take that out of the set list for that
I
night?
Forgot he was there. Yeah. And I forgot he was there on this one, too. I was talking some shit. What was my last joke? Oh, God. What was my last? Oh, it was about a clit.
Yeah?
Yeah, it was about a clit. What was I talking about? Oh, I was talking, I do that trans joke where I say, you know, when the guy's like, why would you let a trans girl suck your dick?
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that gay? I'm like, there's different levels of gay. Would I let a hot chick with beautiful breasts and an awesome penis suck my dick? 100% yes.
Yeah.
Would I let a diehard Yankee fan suck my dick? No. And I acted it out. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Appreciate that.
You acted out the blowjob?
I forgot.
The two different ones?
I forgot.
Show me the difference.
Well, the first one is, you know, the head's going down, and the second one is like, dude, it's like you hold it like a bat day at Yankee. what's up, dude? Don't Dude, don't come on my hat. This is my Jeter hat.
Judge's toe's going to be better soon.
Dude, we're going to win this year, dude.
I did.
Fuck the Red Sox, dude.
I don't want to derail you. My wife's dad is staying with us. He's got full-on dementia.
Well, that must be fun.
Yeah, it's great.
Just reintroducing yourself every 5 minutes.
Hi, I'm your son-in-law. Hi, I'm your son-in-law. Want some crackers? Hi, I'm your son-in-law.
It's like living a shitty Robin Williams movie.
I did this act out to him. I go, hey, Bob, you remember these days? And I started sucking the shaft, playing with the balls. And my wife got so offended. And Bob is dying laughing. Dying laughing.
And then he forgot about it 2 seconds later.
Yeah, he doesn't know. He's got the fucking brain capacity of a fish. He doesn't know what's happening. So you're doing the act out of these two blowjobs. Max is watching.
Well, he came out after, and I was like, Max, you got to, whatever said here is jokes. You don't bring, I don't want to hear about it.
Yeah.
Don't bring it up again. He's like, I got it, cool. We had the best night. Went over the cellar, we got food. Me and him sat at one of the tables and just made each other laugh.
Yeah.
Like, it was weird to hang out with my son, but we were kind of really hanging. Then he hung out the table with everybody, no problem. I left him there.
Yeah.
And then we, after the shows, we jumped in the car. We were talking on the way. He was playing Five Finger Death Punch because he was going to see him. He loves him.
Yeah.
And then when we got home the next day, we're having breakfast, and we were all sitting, me, Don, and him. He's like, Dad, what's a clit? And I was like, fuck.
You broke bro code. You said what happens on the road stays on the road.
I know.
You didn't teach him that yet.
I told him, I go, dude, you weren't supposed to say nothing, and it's a little penis.
Yeah.
Technically.
It's good that you told him.
It's a little dick.
It's good that he knows. Did you bring this up when you were mentioning how Bud Light had totally shifted their ads?
Dude, I'm proud of Bud Light. They just went to gay juice. They're just full gay. They had a float.
Yeah.
And they changed the can color to rainbow.
But you didn't see the new commercial that they released. That's all like straight white guys.
What?
They released a new commercial like 3 days ago to try and get back the MAGA crew.
Dude, they had a float in the parade.
They were hoping no one told anybody. You just ruined it for Bud Light.
What do you mean?
They wanted that on the down low.
You can't have it on the down low. It's the biggest gay pride. They had 75 queens on it. Shaking their asses.
Really?
Yeah, dude. You didn't see that? Bud Light.
It's gay juice? Is that
gay,
what
yeah. Drink this and you become hotter.
Do you think gay men like Bud Light? I don't think they do.
They do the spritzer they just came out with. The summertime spritzer. Yeah.
You got to have a spritzer.
Okay, dude, if
I was gay, I would go support Bud Light. That's all we would drink if I was gay. Fuck it. Go make that $40 million back, baby.
Look at this. They came back with a new white guy commercial and people
You mean a regular commercial?
Yeah. Because beer commercials used to be all about what is now termed toxic masculinity.
Right.
But it was all like tits, having fun.
Hey, what's up? What's up?
Date rape. Remember that one? Remember
that one? Just some hot chick in a bikini with three tits.
Stella Artois. She's popping the bottle with two of her tits squeezing
them together. Nipple.
Yeah. This was like this new commercial that they did to try and win the white guys back. And their Twitter feed, they started limiting mentions because people were like, nah, you guys are traitors. I'm never supporting you. Here it is.
This is a thermometer. It's 100 degrees.
Yeah.
And it's in a backyard where beer should be.
In a backyard.
In a backyard with a bunch of men. Right? And women cooking somewhere, right? Girl, right, Christine?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, shit. All right, Jesus
Real
Christ.
Real stuff.
She ain't going to take my shit.
You wouldn't let
She'll take Jay's shit, but she ain't taking my shit.
You wouldn't let a woman near a grill in a beer commercial.
Well, you can't let her near a grill in life.
Yeah. You shut everything down.
I'm going to tell you something. Christine, I love women. You know that.
Yeah, of course.
I'm not a woman. You don't let your wife near the grill.
No.
I grill. The summertime, I'm cooking most of the time.
I cook most of the time anyways.
The last time I let Dawn use the grill, okay, I pulled up. The grill is on fire.
Yeah.
I'm talking fire.
Fire.
It's supposed to be on fire, not on fire. To
right.
make a grill light on fire is almost humanly impossible. Okay.
Me and Jay almost got, when we stayed at the house this summer earlier, we went to go turn on the grill and it just like wasn't working properly. And all of a sudden, I mean, there was a, it felt like an explosion. It was really like subtle, but it really blew up at us.
You guys are both stoned out of your fucking mind. If you got, you turned the gas on.
You turned the gas on, but you didn't light it. And then you lit it. And then there was a whole bunch of gas.
It was,
and then
3 hours later, they woke up and they were like, hey, are we good barbecuing? Yeah. And Christine's eyebrows are gone.
Jay's gloves are all burned.
So, A.
What?
He doesn't wear gloves anymore.
Not anymore?
You need to talk about my fucking co-host.
The gloves are gone?
I'm very... No,
he's changed. Come on, he's flying JetBlue.
He's Delta Lounge, baby. We're Lounge Brothers.
All right.
Listen, dude, we don't fucking... That's a thing to get back to the show.
Okay.
He's a Delta loyal lounge person. We live lounge life. We're platinum... Okay,
yeah,
and we do
too.
Lounge life.
You don't gotta convince me.
All right. Come, just
I go to the lounge after my flight too.
That's,
and I'll wait, and I time it so that my bags, even if they're late, I'll just go up to the late desk and go, hey, my bags aren't on the carousel
anymore.
He
told me that you do that. It's almost ridiculous.
Why? It's another free meal.
It's,
what's wrong with you?
Yeah, why do old Jewish comics really just become about the meal?
Because the meal's the best part.
You and stupid Voss, call him, where are you? I'm at this club called Sickles. Where? I don't know, they got good salmon. What? Yeah, they got a good salmon dish. And I'm golfing. What is it about the meal?
The meal's a nice part.
The meal is
you
part
get
of
to
it.
Eat free a good meal. It's very exciting.
I go home, I eat. Listen, here's the deal.
Yeah.
What was I talking about? Oh, what the fuck was I talking about before you sidetracked me?
You're talking about the barbecue. How do you do all the
I come
grilling?
Home, the fucking grill's on fire. She's standing in front of it, looking at it.
Yeah.
She's not doing anything. Lou, staring at the fire, the grill on fire. I pull up, I go, the grill's on fire. She goes, I know.
Yeah.
Put it out.
Yeah.
She goes, with what? There's a pool behind her. I go, with what they've been using to put fire out with. For fucking centuries.
Did she think you meant roll the barbecue into the pool?
I don't... there's a fucking pool behind her.
Yeah. Can't just go... Come on. You think she's going to think, go grab a bucket of pool water and throw it on the barbecue?
If something's on fire, use water. How's that? Except for when?
Yeah.
When it's grease.
That's correct.
Yes. Here's the thing. I grabbed the water, it popped the grill.
Yeah.
But it was a Weber because I'm a professional. Mm-hmm. They replaced everything, 10-year warranty, rebuilt my grill from scratch.
Wow.
100% Weber. That's why you pay the extra money.
Yeah.
Don't get a kitchenette. You get a kitchenette, don't talk to me.
I got a Dynaglow and we got problems.
You have a Dynaglow?
Yeah.
What the fuck is that?
The bottom fell out yesterday.
Yeah, dude. Don't talk to me.
It's a Dynaglow.
I expect more from you.
This is why I eat at the lounge. I don't want to be home barbecuing.
Get a Weber. You get a Weber. It's a 10-year warranty.
Yeah.
Anything happens, they replace it. You call a lovely lady up. You go, my grill blew up. My wife lit it on fire. Okay, we'll send you a new one out. They sent all the parts out. I took pictures. 2 days later, the whole grill back.
You just got new parts or a whole new grill.
They gave me new everything that I needed.
Oh, look at that. 829. Yeah.
Weber
that's a
grill.
Good Weber.
Unbelievable.
Right. Yeah,
you don't let a woman near a grill. No offense. I don't want to be a chauvinist, Christine. I apologize.
But it does seem like it's a traditionally, it's like where the men cook, because it always seems like women are the ones cooking, except for if the grill, it's like the men take it over. It's kind of nice, actually.
Dawn hired a female chef 1 year for our barbecue.
Uh-oh.
I don't know if you remember that.
Oh, boy. Oh, yeah, that's when your house burnt down.
No. I looked over, and she's barbecue. I have 60 people there.
Yeah.
She's putting a hamburger, space, hamburger, space, hamburger. Hamburger, space, hamburger, space, hamburger. Hot dog, space, hot dog, space, hot dog. I have 60 people there.
Yeah.
I have a bunch of kids. I probably have around 15 kids running around, starving.
Yeah.
I walked over, I go, hamburger, 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 hamburger.
No space.
Hot dog, hot dog, hot dog, hot dog, hot dog. Flip, 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 flip. Get it in their fucking mouths.
Yeah.
You don't, this isn't a fucking Michelin star restaurant. This is a backyard in White Plains.
Yeah.
I want this over. I want their bellies full. Sitting down, stuff them with pasta salad, get some stuff. We have some ice cream. 6 o'clock, everybody goes. Yeah. And then I put the steak tips on when they're full.
So yeah.
They don't eat all that fucking thing.
Steak tips
are
the best part.
If you have something good, if you got steaks, you get the hamburgers, hot dogs on first.
Yeah.
Fill the people you don't like.
Yeah, because people are hungry. They're like, I want to eat right when we get here.
You want
to go, dude, there's burgers and dogs there. Then they stuff up. Stuff and then you up. Go, oh, the steak tips for anyone that's still hungry.
You stuff them
or
up.
Or my good friends.
You look and you see them rubbing their bellies. Then you throw the good meat on.
Your steak tips are the
and
best.
And then they're like, ah, oh, shit.
Yeah.
But you give the QT to your friends. Dude, hold off on that.
Yeah.
Hold off a little bit on that. Don't eat too much.
Yeah, you've said that to me before.
Yeah, I have. Of course, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. If I offer you, if I give you a plate and has two hot dogs and two hamburgers on it.
I'm on the naughty list.
I don't like you.
Yeah.
I don't like you.
I get it.
Yeah, if you have like a hamburger, and I go, just hold off a little bit, I got some steak tips coming.
You want to see this white guy commercial?
Yeah, I do.
Watch this.
That's not a white guy. There's a black guy right there. Oh shit!
Oh man, segregation. You dumb bitch.
I love it. They got the fridge in the garage, the old white fridge.
Yeah.
Where it should be. There you go. Right through the screen. That happened last year. A couple dogs looking at you like an idiot.
Yeah, you idiot.
You reach in for the Bud Light. There's a tornado. I don't know why there's a fucking tornado. What the?
Guy can't sit on a hammock. Watch out.
Who can? Those hammocks suck. Shooting the basketball, gets stuck. They got a keg.
That's can't open the keg properly.
Chubby black guy.
Yeah.
There you go. I think that's an Indian dude too. Throw that in. Yeah. Why not? Nice mixed neighborhood. I like this commercial.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Easy to drink. Easy to enjoy.
But look on the pink flamingo float. There's two drag queens in the pool. Did you see that? They snuck them in.
At the end of the Bud Light commercial, what if they said totally not gay?
Yeah.
Totally not gay.
Yeah, we're not gay anymore.
I don't mind it. You mind it?
I don't mind the gays.
I don't think gay people like that beer.
Gay people hate beer.
Yeah.
They like mixed drinks. They like fun glasses.
Yeah.
They want to get drunk.
Yeah.
They don't want to have to drink six things to get drunk.
All bloated.
No.
Farting to an anal.
Yeah, they don't want that. What was that? Hops?
Yeah.
No
malted hops in your belly.
No hot trans girl wants a hops fart.
Mm-mm.
You know what I mean? Have sex later.
What about an ugly trans girl? She doesn't mind a hops fart?
No, not even an ugly trans girl wants a hops fart.
Can we play that SNL sketch where they do the gay beer commercial?
Sure. Let's play it.
Schlitz gay.
Schlitz gay.
Oh, yeah, that's fun. Let's watch commercials.
I love it. Gay people are taking over everything.
I drank a real beer by accident since I've been sober, you know?
That's good.
It's not good. Someone brought it to me. I ordered can you bring me an alcohol-free beer? They brought it in a pint glass, which I should have known. I drank it an hour later. I'm like, why is my head hurt?
How long have you been sober?
9.5 years.
When did you have the beer?
Maybe 4 or 5 years ago.
So you're 5 years sober. That's good.
Don't fuck with my numbers.
I mean, it's technically.
What are you doing?
I've been sober 38 years. Never had a drop. Listen, thing is.
4 decades?
Yep, 4 decades.
Fuck yeah.
Fuck yeah, yep.
I'm going to dose you at Skankfest.
Don't do that.
Yep.
Ari Shaffir. Go ahead. It was a door knocker.
This is the great house sitting deal that you found.
This, Furley, Adam,
this place is a doll.
Furley and
just
Adam
wait
Sandler.
Till you see the pool.
In the,
no
in
water?
The backyard.
Whoa.
It's just all dudes.
Just hot.
Yeah, listen.
Good
dude,
body dudes.
Yeah. That's a different type of gay, though.
Yeah, those are male strippers. They're just gay for pay.
Yeah, they're gay for pay. That don't count. Schlitz gay.
On my way to the gay pride parade yesterday, that's kind of what I saw, and I didn't go.
You went to the gay pride parade?
I avoided it.
How did you avoid it? By going to it?
I went back to Jersey, and my girl went without me.
You didn't go to it at all?
No. There was a guy with a short sequin.
How did you see that?
Because we were in Queens at a diner having lunch, and she's begging me to go because her birthday's tomorrow. Like, that has anything to do with anything.
Yeah.
So I'm like, nah, dude, I'm out. Look at that fucking guy. There's going to be 10,000 of them.
Yeah.
At least.
You got too hard, and you were like, I can't take it.
Yeah. Too much.
Too hard?
I support everybody. Be free. Yes. But just, I don't want to see all that anymore.
Yeah, not at once, because you'll just explode like that fucking submarine.
Not anymore.
You'll just implode. Your dick will poof like 2 seconds. Yeah.
Fool me twice. Shame on me.
Yep. Fool you 5 times. Fun for us.
Not again.
Okay. I bet you went home and ordered a nice 6-pack of Bud Light and sat on your back porch and watched it from the privacy of your own home.
You know, I worked at Gay Pride Parade once.
As what?
Like a bartender at a lesbian bar called Slack Alice in Toronto.
Slack Alice.
And I wore a sarong, and I just went out and I'd serve beer to all these gay guys, and they were really great. And then the guy that owned the place tried to kiss me on the mouth once.
And what'd you do?
I let him kiss me on the mouth.
Nice. Good for you, dude.
It felt weird. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, it felt weird because it was the first time.
Nah.
Second time didn't feel that weird, right?
It felt weird. The stubble felt weird.
Sure.
He was such a nice guy. I didn't want to say no and push him away.
Yeah, you got to just make out with an Italian girl. The stubble goes away. You get used to it.
Just leaned in.
Ease into it. You can't just make out with a guy.
Kiss my mouth. You never kissed a guy on the mouth at a pride parade?
No. I've never been to a pride parade.
Yeah.
Never in my life.
I've been to a couple when I was a stripper. They made us dance upstairs and the people would look at us and stuff. It was pretty gay.
Well, I just never been. It's too much for me. I don't like lines. I don't like all this. I don't like after the parade. The
parades are busy.
I used to like a parade back at like an Americana parade.
Yeah.
You go downtown, you get a little chair and
Tom Cruise coming in a wheelchair and his legs don't work because of NOM and stuff like that. The
fire truck comes by.
Yeah, he's all slobbering. People are clapping at him like he's a hero, but while you're clapping, all he hears is shrapnel and bullets instead of the claps.
Yeah.
Remember that great and he's just, then he's got to go get drunk afterwards.
Yeah, it's like a 20-minute parade.
Yeah, he's just peeing his pants because he can't get up.
I like a 20-minute parade.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's just over. I don't like an all-day just gay fest.
Yeah.
Because then it spills over into everything and...
Everything. Oh, it's the whole town.
It's the whole town. Even like with the regular parades, it's like there's like everywhere you go is a firefighter trying to punch you in the face, you know?
Parades blow.
Yeah, they do. Parades suck.
I went to go watch. I like the spectacle of it. And I still am like, you know, Pride started as a protest.
you like the...
Christine was our bonfire reporter. She said there were a bunch of... She was watching kids watch a bunch of nasty stuff.
Yeah.
That was... I said to the people I was with, I was like, I'm really conflicted about kids being here because on one hand, you're like, okay, it's a celebration and all that, but it's not really a family-friendly event. Like, it's really graphic and there's a lot going on and it just doesn't seem like... And they're also kids without like cans on at all, and it's very loud.
It's loud, and then they got to watch some 65-year-old guy with tube socks and tighty whities sticking something in his asshole in a fountain.
I love the spectacle of it, though.
We
found a nice corner. Like we were off in a little shaded corner, and was able to like watch without being too in it.
Watch them indoctrinating these kids. That's what people get upset about, Bobby.
I know. Well,
the people with no kids, and I'm surprised Christine is taking the right moral stance on this, but people with no kids are like, there's nothing wrong with this. And I get it because there's a lot of gay parents now. So they want to take their kids with them and be like, hey, look at the struggle we've overcome. This is awesome. But then they see it and they're like, why has that guy got those clamps on his nipples and stuff like that?
Yeah, why does that guy have a bulge and tits?
There has to be a better way to teach kids about gay pride.
I've had trans people in my son's life his whole life. Mm-hmm. I had Bailey J was at his fifth birthday party. You know, I mean, I don't think you make your kid. You can't make your kid gay.
No.
You know what I mean? Like Max.
We have gay neighbors and we've gone to the town and protested, but they're still really nice people.
Yeah, you can't. I mean, you're talking about. Raising your kid in a certain way where you don't want sex in his life. You don't want him to see sex. That's just how you don't, you know, some people don't care about sex. Some people don't care about tits and dick and shit like that. So they'll bring their kids down and there's a bunch of naked people and guys making out and penises and assholes and they don't give a shit. But some people, you know, don't want that.
I mean, there was a girl, she was so fucking hammered, and I don't know if she, I think she was with her gay friend, but she had her skirt up around her ass. I mean, it was like, you know, her fucking vagina was out.
It was Dawn. I told her, that's why I had to bring Max to the cellar. Dawn was down there just showing her asshole to everybody.
She's like drunk and unaware. Like, this isn't even people in the parade. Like, people on the sidelines are like ridiculous.
It's gotten a little out of hand.
It's always been out of hand.
Not always.
Come on.
No, not always.
It's always been pretty...
It's been crazy.
It's always been pretty crazy. I mean,
it's a Kalian ritual, if that's the right way to say it.
I don't even know what that means, so yes.
Drunken, over the top. They're having a great time.
He's trying to say bacchanal?
Yeah, thanks, man.
Nice.
But thanks, Lou. Most gay people I know in comedy are so gay, they're over it. They're like, I don't even celebrate Pride Month.
A lot of gays are kind of turning on the other part.
Yeah.
They're like, look, man, we just want to be regular parents, and we don't want to be, you know, all that crazy shit. And they're like, fuck you. The gay pride parade has gone too far.
Yeah.
I know gay parents that are like, we're not going. We'll bring our kids there.
No.
No, because they don't want them to be exposed to that wild shit.
You want your kids to learn about sex when you think it's ready. But they're going to do it earlier than you think
it's
ready.
Yeah, you want them walking on you and mom, go, what the hell are you doing to mom?
Yeah.
Why does she look so bored?
Yeah.
Why is mom reading a book on her iPad?
Why are you just masturbating on top of her?
Yeah, why are you jerking off in a sauna by yourself, Dad?
FaceTime and mom.
All right, we're going to take a break. We're going to get an update when we come back. Jay is on his way. We have Aaron Berg. Be sure to check out his new show, Street Famous NYC, available now at patreon.com/streetfamousnyc. I've watched a bunch of the episodes. You're fearless out there. You got to be fearless.
Thanks, brother.
Perfect guy to do that. One of my favorite guys in the biz. I love you so much, and thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
Of course, Big J is going to be, he's got a whole thing going on. He's on the Fully Loaded tour, June and July. So this is not the first time this is going to happen. We're going to have a guest host every Monday in case Delta fucks him again. JetBlue stinks. August 10th through the 12th, Legion of Skanks tour, which is, you can't miss that. Get the tickets if they're not already gone. And he's going to be in New Hampshire, Boston, Connecticut. For tickets and all other dates, please go to BigJComedy.com and check me out at RobertKellyLive.com. I got a bunch of theater dates going on this summer in New Hampshire, and I'm going to be in Las Vegas and Rutherford, New Jersey, and Rochester. RobertKellyLive.com. We'll be right back. It's the Bonfire, everybody. There's nothing wrong with loving who you
are. No, you're gay. Get away from me.
All right, you ready? This is Bert Kreischer, the machine! And you're listening to The Bonfire with Big J, Oaks, and Robert Kelly on Fiction Talk. Faction 103.
It's fiction. It's fiction.
Hey, this is Bert Kreischer, and you're listening to Big J... Hey, this is Bert Kreischer, and listening to The Bonfire with Big J, Oaks, and Robert Kelly on Fiction Faction Talk 103. I'm drunk.
Love them. Love that song. That's a that comes out metal. You're like, oh, this is gonna be fucking hard. And then it goes into that, yeah, I love you. Real passionate, meaningful lyrics. I love meaningful lyrics.
Big J might fucking hate this.
Let's hear right here. Forgive me for the fool that I become. I take back the stupid things I've done. Jay would hate this song.
Yeah.
Since burning away. They pronounce the R's too hard. Burning away. Falsetto. Get. That's my favorite gift. That's it, Jacob. Get into it. Ah, yeah. There you go. You feel it. Get. Fool. I love that song.
It's a good montage song. It's a good montage song.
Yeah, it's a good, like...
trying to win your ex back. You get a job at a diner. You're doing your math homework.
Yeah.
All that stuff.
That's right there when you realize, I got to go get her back. You take your apron, you throw it down. Yeah. You run out. You
She's
run
with the new dude.
But you run into the traffic and run through it. Mm-hmm. And you're running against it. And all the cars are coming at you. They're beeping. What's he doing? Yeah. And you're singing the song. Forgive me
for the fool that I've become.
There you go.
We got somebody on the line right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have an update. We have this is a Bonfire with Big J Oakerson and Robert Kelly. And we have an update, a Big J update. We have Big J update right now. We have a caller right now. Big J, you on the line?
Hey, guys. What's up?
Jay, how you doing? Are you you're almost to us, Jay. We've been here waiting for you. You said that last time we talked to you, you were on the plane, deplaning, and where are you at now?
Well, I don't know. You guys want to know a fun fact. The first place you're able to get a cab or an Uber.
Oh, yeah. JFK is supposed to be a nightmare right now, Bobby. It's not easy to get a cab or an Uber.
Let me tell you something. Do you have Verizon? What do you want right now?
I'm on AT&T.
I can't even hear him.
AT&T, he said.
AT&T. We got to upgrade you to Verizon. You're Delta now, dude. This is very United.
Wait, can I tell you guys, I'm calling in with very important update information.
Okay. We have very important from Jay update information. Go ahead, Jay.
This is big news.
Big news.
Now, our very own Bonfire spokesmodel, Lynn, has officially created an OnlyFans account.
Yay! Oh, look at Jacob just lit up.
That sweet, sweet husband of hers has decided it's okay to share her what's up, and if you know what I mean, with the rest of the world.
Her what's up, and you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Her fiddly diddlies and her dabbity doos.
A fan DM'd me yesterday. I confirmed it with the lady herself.
Oof.
Says, in fact, she does have an OnlyFans up. She doesn't know where it's going to go. That's a quote, which means it can be anything from PG-13 to aggressive anal.
Wow.
It's hard to find out.
Oh, my God. I'm very excited. Have you seen Lynn?
No.
Oh, she is the spokesmodel for the Bonfire, and she is
she's made... She's a woman?
She's made by the gods. She's made by the gods.
Really?
Yeah.
Toward the body.
Yeah, why don't we show her? Christine, can you please bring up Lynn? Thanks very much. There you go. Oh, my God.
Those are nice boobs.
I mean, perfect, I think the word you were.
That's a very attractive woman.
22 yes. years old, two children.
What?
Two children, dude.
Get the...
I will not.
Come on.
I will stay right here because nobody else is here. Jay's
You're lying.
In the car. I have to stay here.
Look at that. She's got a vagina.
Oh, yeah. And a bum. Oh, she has. Yeah.
I respect that.
That's her woohoo, right, Joe? Jay.
She's got the perfect exclamation.
Look at that. Come on.
Just a duker.
Yeah.
Come on.
I mean, it looks like a little hamburger.
I got to punch somebody.
Punch me. Punch
Jesus
me.
Jesus Christ.
Stand on your fucking tippy toes and go over here and punch me
Do
right
you know
in the
what
face.
I would do with that?
Yeah, I know what you'd do that. You'd leave your wife. You'd ruin your life.
No,
that's
I wouldn't.
What you'd do with that.
Somebody call Berg's wife and tell her to get ready to take a punch.
Take a what?
You get a nice fat punch right in the face when you go home.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
I bet that vagina, you could probably put a penis in there.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm thinking house one of the holds a couple babies.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
You'd have to lick that a little bit first. Like,
come on. And she's married to a lovely guy?
Yep.
Yes.
And he's okay with this?
He is a gentleman.
He's so cool with it. He is not even minorly threatened because he moves her out to the farthest points of Texas that no one's ever heard of.
Oh, nice.
So she doesn't know there's other people out there. It's great.
Oh, yeah. Wow. Yeah. He just kind of keeps her at home.
Yeah.
Do you think that this will be a problem when she starts making a whole bunch of money on the OnlyFans?
No, why would it be a problem?
Because if you got a whole bunch of money and you're making it, and then you're like, oh, look at all this money I have with these nice boobs and my vagina that a penis could go in. Maybe I could take this and go to New York City and do like a walkabout.
No.
Let me tell you what's going on here. And I'll tell you, a couple of these metropolitan bitches that we decided to hitch our wagons to.
Metropolitan bitches.
Is that Lynn posts things online, and Jacob can attest to this, and her mind blown. She goes, oh my God, look what my husband did for me today. I'm so thrilled. And it'll be a picture of the big new mom. And I swear to God, that's true.
Say it again, Jay.
I said, you've seen posts before where Lynn will post something about how great her husband is and how good he treats her and how he came through so big this time. And then it's just a picture of like a mop he bought her or a vacuum cleaner.
Yeah, he bought her like a mop. Jay, can I ask you a question? Do you have the guy, the Chinese guy that lets you smoke in the car?
No, but I bribed. I
can tell he's
smoking. So you have the window open, don't you?
No, I don't.
Oh, you don't? Oh, my God. It's very loud in there.
Yeah, it's very loud.
What are you, in a pickup truck?
Yeah, these metropolitan bitches, man. Yeah, they go to Walmart and stuff.
This bitch is happy with a mop.
Yeah. Give my wife a mop.
And then he built her like a rudimentary wooden like cabinet system. And she's just like, this is the greatest thing. And she's so appreciative. Yeah, look at you, Christine. She's very appreciative.
She's 22.
Yeah.
Is that bother you? What does that mean? She's going to grow into her twattiness? Is that what
she'll figure it out.
She's going to figure it out.
10 years. The fuck is this? A fucking BMW? Ugh.
I don't think she is. I think she's what's America. It's what makes America great is women like that. That's the women that built this country right there. Yeah. Right, Jay?
Oh, yeah. That's Trump pussy. Sure.
That's Trump pussy.
Oh, yeah, living in Texas. Oh, look at that nice little area rug she's on, too.
I know. He bought her that at Target.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was $9.99.
Yeah, it's the real small one.
He's a man's man, that Nolan.
Wow. How old's he?
He's 48.
He's 22 also.
I'm kidding. He's 22.
They've been together since high school. She doesn't even know anything else.
Oh, my God.
That.
If I could do it all again.
You'd go back there and steal her from him. We should go out there and see who can take her from him.
Sounds like a really mean game.
By the time we get on the property, there's going to be like 8 throwing axes in us.
Yeah. Boom. Oh. $8.99 a month. There you go. It's not a bad deal.
No, that's a great deal.
$8.99. That's a steal.
Yeah.
I love that she didn't make it $9.99. She saved you a buck.
Yeah.
Do they have any photos at all? Can we see anything?
I've seen enough. I'm good.
Use your platinum. Sign up. Jay, she can use your platinum to sign up, right?
Oh, yes.
3 months?
Oh, goddammit.
24/27 for 3 months.
Off. It's 10% off at 3 months. I love that she's being a nickel chaser even with this.
A nickel chaser.
Do it for 3 months.
3 months.
God damn it. Now I'm giving you money. You have to give exclusive content.
Oh, your payment's in there.
You already paid, you piece of shit?
Let's do it.
Jay,
you signed up.
Jay's, your credit card was already in the fucking thing, Jay. You hunk of shit. Jay's a hunk of shit. Yeah, it was. No. We're looking right at it.
It's been for the show before.
Well, why'd we subscribe to this twice?
Yeah.
I'm just going
to
do this one.
Wow, this is going to be hot.
Yeah, she
I'm pretty excited about this.
Yeah, what do you think the first picture is going to be of?
Me coming?
I think right now it's pretty timid.
Oh, wow.
But
he's naked.
I think we already saw that one.
Yeah.
We saw that one.
I think with our...
That's her with her knee up over her chest.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Those are really good tits. Yeah. And a really good
with
body.
With our inside track.
Two kids.
I think we could progress this to full penetration pretty quickly.
Let's see.
And that is up to us. That's up to us, the bonfire, and the campers.
Yeah. Well, we subscribed for 3 months.
Yeah.
Lynn, you heard it, bro. I think maybe we'll have her call in later this week.
There's her getting drunk on a Corona.
She could plug it, pun intended.
Yeah.
Ooh.
She got some oil on her legs in this picture. She got some shit in her nipples.
Oh, she. She's teasing us though. She's covering her nips in one. We don't get full anything. Is that it? Just four photos?
Yeah, and there's one that said click for a short video.
Boy, we got for $25.
No.
We've already seen as much.
It's for 3 months. There's going to be more content.
Yeah.
What happens if she dies today?
I mean, then we're out $25.
No.
Sorry.
Is the husband a good enough guy? He'd keep it up to date and just be like, here's
just
some
from
pictures.
His camera roll.
Wait, is there a video? It's we see a video?
Sweet, it says, message me if you want to see the full picture plus another and a short video. So,
what a sweet person.
Really nice.
Thanks, Lynn.
Wow. A lot of girls got into that game.
Yeah. Zia got into it, too. Remember, she used to be on Norton. She used to be on Chip Show.
Yeah.
Zia.
Zia got tits.
She got tits, and now she's on this, and you can see
she's not
boobs.
Naked, though.
She's 100% naked.
I disagree with her doing that.
Why?
Because I really feel
like... I thought that girl... I looked at that girl. Any time I find there's a comic who has an OnlyFans, of course I go look.
Yeah.
No, she's naked.
And she has... Is she naked? Because I feel like I saw a bunch of pictures of that Zia girl given like a front wedge and very hot. But I will say this. Oddly colored vag. It's a little dark down there.
Really?
In the lip area. Maybe, I feel like it is.
Maybe she used the Paris filter.
Which maybe, listen, I'm not walking away from it. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that it seems like, yeah.
You really can get them for anything.
What do you mean? What do you mean, Christine?
Maybe there's some turf burn on those things.
Feminist Christine sticking up for women again.
No, yeah. Jay's got a knack. He can find the most perfect chick and he'll tell you the flaw.
Yeah, you mean he's got a superhero power?
Not my Lynn. That's Lynn, why.
Lynn's perfect.
That's why she's our spokesmodel. Not my Lenny.
Oh, Lenny.
Oh, she got beautiful hips.
Call her Lenny now. That's my new thing. I call her Lenny. I still call Christine, full name, every time.
You haven't given her a nickname? No. Huh? There's no nickname for Christine?
Yeah, we started calling her Steen because that's what Isabella's sister calls her, and then Christine yelled at me one day for it.
Yeah,
that's kind of.
I call my Christine. I go, hey, not Jay's Christine. That's what I yell into the kitchen.
It's better than be called not Dan.
Christine Berg.
Yeah. Hey, Christine Berg.
He used to call me beautiful. Now he calls me Steen.
Did he call you beautiful at one time?
Forever. Still sometimes in text.
Oh, that's so nice.
It is nice.
Yeah, well, that's back when she was beautiful.
Oh, stop it, Jay. Christine is still beautiful.
Now I'm Steen.
I know she is. I know she
Christine,
is.
Christine is, she's like the Indian chief's daughter. Not the first one, like the third one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Someone must have married you.
The one that had the husband die.
Her husband deceased when the wild buffalo done step on her.
You take my daughter. No, not that one. The one... The third one in the back.
The used one.
The one that's crying all the time.
We smoke them half-empty peace pipe.
You take the one on Ozempic. She eats half a beaver tail.
Oh, speaking of which, Jay, you got to take our dose out when you get home.
Oh, yeah, we got a dose.
Oh, Ozempic. You know they're coming out with the pill, Jay.
I did see that.
Yep, now you don't have to shoot each other in the stomach like heroin addicts every Sunday.
Monday.
Monday, oh, wow. Sorry. Ozempic.
I like to be just going to lay there and listen to some tunes.
Yeah, and just shoot each other up in the gut.
Riders on the Storm.
Jay, we're going to play a game today. We're going to play a really great game for the fans because you're not here.
Mm-hmm.
Did we come up with a name? What's the name of it? Is it Jay? Where was it, right? Here it is right here. Ready? Hey, everybody. Robert Kelly, Big J on the phone, Aaron Berg in studio, DJ Lou and Christine, Jacob, he's home in the place he loves so much, Florida. We're going to play a little game today. Did Jay say it or someone else? These are quotes that we're going to be reading. We have a bunch of different ones, and you have to answer, did Jay say it or was it someone else?
Okay.
Here we go. The first quote. When I was young, I used to masturbate to Gilligan's Island. Was that Big J or Ron Jeremy? Christine?
Ron Jeremy.
DJ Lou?
That's Big J.
Big J. Jacob.
Big J.
Big J. Aaron.
Big J.
The answer is Ron Jeremy, everybody.
Ron Jeremy.
Ron Jeremy. Christine, you were right.
I think I would have heard of that.
I found pornography pretty young.
We have another question here. This is another. Was it Big J or somebody else? I'm your host, Robert Kelly, with my sidekick, Aaron Bergen, today. I would stab my mother in the face. Big J or Charles Manson? DJ Lou.
Both of them.
good answer. Christine.
J.
J. Big J. Okay, great. Aaron Berg.
Big J.
Jacob.
I was going to say Manson, but can Christine go last so that our questions are locked in?
Sure.
Yeah.
Good way. Good,
because
good thinking.
Because now she's swaying me.
She sways a lot of people.
I'm going to stick with Manson.
Answer is?
Big J.
Big J. You know his mom was a randy woman out there.
Look, she got around for sure, but that's not why I was going to stab her in the face. It was a hypothetical. It's out of context for Big J.
It's out of context for Big J.
I think he would say, like,
I knew what it was for.
I said I would stab her in the face for one day with a slightly larger penis.
Oh, okay.
All right, here we go.
That's all.
We're heading into round two of the Was It Big J or Someone Else? Every single girl will sleep with you for money. They just have different prices. Big J or Andrew Tate? Jacob, go with you. Big J just went, I said, Big J or Andrew Tate? Every single girl will sleep with you for money. They just have different prices. Big J or Andrew Tate? Your answer is, Jacob.
I'm saying Big J on this one.
Big J, great. Aaron Berg.
Andrew Tate.
Andrew Tate. DJ Lou.
Big J.
Big J. Christine.
Andrew Tate.
The answer is... Andrew Tate, everybody. Andrew Tate said that.
Well, I gotta give you a hard agree over here, though.
They both said it. One said it out loud. The other one said it in his heart.
Jay, don't publicly agree with Andrew Tate.
Oh, yeah. He's a bad guy, right?
Here we go. Are you ready?
Yes.
We're still in round two. We filmed a lot of stuff. They're gone now because they're child pornography. Big J or Jared from Subway? Big J or Jared from Subway? Lock in your answers. Aaron Berg, we're going to start with you.
Jared from Subway.
Big J can't answer. DJ Lou, your answer, please.
Jared Subway.
Jared Subway, great. Jacob, answer from you, please.
Believe this is Jared from Subway, but it's throwing me off because I think Jay's mentioned that he had taped something when he was a teenager, but now it would be considered.
Yeah, you're supposed to do this in your head, Jacob.
Well, I thought it would be fun to,
no, I'm kidding,
to think it out loud.
But please, think it out loud.
Jared, I'm going to stick with Jared from Subway.
Jared from Subway. We have three Jared from Subway. Christine, it is up to you. Is it Big J or Jared from Subway?
It's wildly out of context, but I agree with, like, Jacob about what he is saying about having done stuff when he was a teenager. So I'm going to say J.
You're going to say Big J. The answer is... Big J. Christine wins again.
Wow.
You know, it could have been either one.
Yeah. It was completely in context, too. I have quite a library.
Okay, here we go. We have some more questions. Are you ready?
Yes.
This one. Who said this quote? I would cook it and look at the pictures and masturbate. Is that Big J or Jeffrey Dahmer? Lock him in. We're going to start with DJ Lou. Your answer, please.
That is Big J Okerson.
That is Big J Okerson. Okay. We got Aaron Berg, please.
Big J.
Big J. Jesus Christ. Jacob, your answer, please.
I pulled these questions, so I should probably remain anonymous.
Well, nobody knew that, so you can play the game.
Well,
I mean, it is a game. We're entertaining people driving in a fucking truck right now on 95. We're just trying to make people happy so they can get home to their parents. We don't have to reveal everything. Nobody's investigating the show, Jacob. What the fuck?
I have to recuse myself.
Yeah, you're not on trial.
I wanted to be honest with the public.
Well, don't be honest with them. They don't want honesty. Well, they want fun. So
that's the only Jacob question.
Okay, that is the only one you did. Pulled, that is so. The only one you pulled. So, all right, Christine.
Jeffrey Dahmer,
because she fucking look at her face. And the answer is Jeffrey Dahmer, everybody. Jeffrey Dahmer.
Boo.
Two people that looked at the question beforehand and are coming fucking new. All right, here we go. These you don't know.
It was a good question, though, because I like fucking and I like eating.
Again, all right. It could have been either one.
Okay, here we go. We are in the third round. This is the speed round of Who Said It? Big J or someone else? I'm loving this game, by the way.
Mm-hmm. It's a fun game.
It's a fun game.
Good game.
We could do this with everybody. We could do it with you, Christine.
I think we got to start doing some games. We got to start doing games and giving out 3 month subscriptions to Lynn's OnlyFans as prizes.
Yes. We could do this with you, Christine. Who said it? Christine or Charles Mann? Stab those pigs in the fucking belly. Kill them all.
Christine.
All right, here we go. Who believes that Chris Cornell's death was not a suicide but an accidental choke jerk? Is that Big J, Joe Rogan, Vicky Cornell, the wife? There's three in that. This is the speed round. There's three possibilities. Again, Joe Rogan, Big J, Vicky Cornell, the wife. Who said that? Who believes that?
I have to recuse myself because I wrote it.
Don't. Nobody knows the fucking inner workings.
God,
what do you? Damn, I mean, do you think when?
Damn good. When I understand. I'm in the back of a fucking Ford Fiesta.
What the fuck? I mean, do you think the writer of Jimmy Kimmel's joke comes out in the middle? Hey, I wrote that one. That one was mine. Nobody cares.
Hey, you guys are wondering why I didn't laugh at that. I wrote it.
Okay. Aaron Berg.
You're Big J.
Big J. Great. Christine.
J.
I don't like your confidence.
I mean, it's a
Jacob.
Whole...
I'm going to say J.
Okay. The answer is... J! It's J, everybody. The host that waits too long. I'm the host that waits too long to give the answer.
I contact with everybody.
Do you know how annoying people is who say it? People are turning their volume. They think they lost satellite.
Oh, you got to do one of those deal or no deals too, where you go like, then the answer is.
All right, here we go. Ready?
Coming up when we come back.
We have, okay. Who said this quote? What would be more embarrassing, seeing period blood through your pants or listening to Ed Sheeran?
It's Sheeran.
Yeah, that too. Sheeran. I'm not a sissy, so I don't know his name.
Dude, the concert was so good a week and a half ago at MetLife.
Did you have to put your lifts in to see it?
It was so good. I had front row seats up
top. You have to. You can't see
it. Yeah, I know. That's why I always book first row.
Is this Big J Okerson or Liza Traeger? Big J Okerson or Liza Traeger? Lock in your answers, please. And here we go. Jacob, what is your answer, please?
I know Jay has publicly mocked Ed Sheeran. I do not believe.
What the?
I know he detests Ed Sheeran.
Everybody's really trying to answer these. Everybody's CSI.
Yeah, I'm trying to think it out.
I love you. Good. It's awesome.
But then, like, period, like, I imagine, like, a chick comic would say that. I'm going to say... Jay.
We have one Jay. Aaron Berg.
Traeger.
We have one Traeger. DJ Lou.
Liza.
We have two Lisas, one Jay. Christine, your answer, please.
Liza.
We have three Lisas, one Jay. And the answer is... Lisa Traeger, that's it! And that is the show for today, everybody. The game show, the new game show on the Bonfire. Was it Big J or somebody else? Join us next week. We're playing with Christine. Is it Christine or was it somebody else?
It was a good mix of Big J or somebody else.
It was a good mix.
Yeah.
We did a lot of production. I don't know if we had to reveal the magic trick.
Boy.
It's not illusion. Look, there's rope.
You got to go.
I don't know why Lou did it again.
I don't know. We just said it, and then you did it again. Why would you do that, Lou?
I don't know.
Were you still flustered from being in the parade yesterday?
No, I wasn't flustered. I did it on purpose.
Okay, I did it on
Were
purpose.
You in costume actually parading? Is that why you weren't
Lou,
there?
Lou, how'd you do on the float?
I couldn't take it. Fuck those people.
Jesus Whoa. Christ. Whoa.
Whoa.
Wow.
Not every single one of them.
Oh, these fucking aliens.
Wow, dude.
The jersey comes out of Lou, huh?
I mean, wow.
T-neck.
That really...
Hey, T-neck.
On a side note here, as I'm driving through the city here, all these posters for Hannah Gadsby and Pablo Picasso that they have up for her art installment.
Yeah.
Hannah Gadsby looks like Harry Potter's father.
No, you mean the foster father that he stayed with?
Yeah. She really has a... She's like a John Goodman now.
Yeah, she's at the stand tonight on the 8 o'clock show.
Oh, wow.
That's not true.
I know.
That's not true at all.
Let's go see her. Let's go to the concert. Let's go to that. Since you're taking me to shitty concerts, let's go see that.
Oh, yeah. We've got to go Gatsby Live.
Yeah, let's go there and wait in a fucking merch line for 3 hours.
Isn't she, like, curating a museum?
I don't know.
She's curating... it's just like an art installment. It's like a piece.
Ugh.
She's curating mediocre Picasso comedy.
Yeah,
it's problematic.
I think Pablo Picasso raped her or something.
Yeah.
Oh, no shit.
Van Gogh left his ear in me pussy. Yeah.
Was that an Australian accent?
I'm doing my best.
I'm doing my best. I am too, dude. It's hard doing impressions on the show. Trust me. I got Joe Pesci. That's it.
If you found Hannah Gadsby's rapist, you think you would be like, no, she used to be hotter.
I tried to put a finger in. She said no once, but then I kept going. That was all that happened.
I was like, come on, bro.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah, he wasn't even into girls. He was into guys.
Yeah.
He bummed out.
Ugh, what's this wet spot, dude? It's me pussy.
Dude, your chest is hot, but your fucking dick sucks.
Bro, what the fuck?
She really does. She dresses very manly. She has like 5 shirts on. She dresses like a dad that's in town visiting his daughter at college.
Yeah. I'm an art history prof back at Berkeley. Like that type of look.
Yeah.
Her elbows and arms look like those bags you put frosting in to frost the cake.
Hannah Gadsby's an ugly man and an uglier woman.
I think she's a cute man. Not that bad.
She's all right. No, she looks like the Man versus Food guy.
She looks too intense for me. Look at those rape eyes.
You mean been raped eyes?
Yeah.
That's a big difference.
I guarantee you she gets rough with her partner.
How?
Yo, Chris, hey, Christine.
All that weight.
Yeah.
If Gatsby was a guy, he could get it, right?
I could get it?
He could get it.
Like I'm saying, you'd bang if I had Gatsby if it was a guy.
Guy Gatsby?
You like her?
Yeah, Guy Gatsby.
Is that your type?
Yeah.
Is that why you're not into me? Because I'm too cool looking. You don't like skinny
I'm
Bobby.
I'm all about Gatsby.
You like Fat Bobby, didn't you?
I mean, Fat Bobby's more my speed.
Yeah.
I don't like that. That makes me sad.
Yeah, you shrunk your way right on Christine's snatch.
I'll get some corduroys and a barracuda jacket if that's what you're into.
Hannah Gatsby's not even like, Hannah's actually like, you know, she's fucking pretty. Her face is very symmetrical. She just always looks pissed off and angry
right,
and upset.
All right, guys, enjoy the rest of your show. I'll see you guys later. Bye.
Where are you going? What's wrong? Come on.
You think
Jay?
He's going to make
I'm
it
like,
here?
Jay's gone. You walked the host of the show.
By the end of the show, he'll be here, right?
He's on his way here now, man.
Yeah.
He's supposed to be here. Right, guys? We're all We're all expecting to walk through that door any second.
You're going to be so happy, like you missed him a lot.
Oh, no, I'm happy you came in. It was a fun show.
Yeah, it was a
he
fun show.
He was still on the show. I'm good with that. You know? Yeah. We got to, perfect timing. What a fun day. I'm going to take a little break now. I'm going to pay some bills. Jay's calling me, probably to yell at Christine. Fucking bitch. She's going to take it too far. Hannah Gatsby's in town. Make sure you check out Aaron Berg, his new show, Street Famous NYC, available now at patreon.com/streetfamous. And go to bigjcomedy.com. He is on the Fully Loaded Tour, the Skankfest Tour. He is everywhere, every weekend. Go get tickets right there at bigjcomedy.com and robertkellylive.com. I'm going to be all over this summer, too, while I'm up in New Hampshire in my little tiny house. And, of course, we're going to be here every Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday for you guys. It's The Bonfire. We'll be right back. I'm just trying to make some
sense. And now back to The Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Robert Kelly.
That's for Big J.
Dude, that Ed Sheeran riff is hot.
It's hot. It's a great new song. Oh, love this. I was learning how to play this on the drums back in the day when I was playing the drums all the time. Oh, I love this. Big J hung up on Christine because she got fucking too silly.
Upset. This is the worst I've seen them fight ever.
He just texted me. I hung up. My fury that Christine called Gatsby pretty. What a loop. Called you a loop.
Texted me.
That's his favorite word for me.
Dude, please tell her this. It's over. Tell her to get her shit out of the house.
Yeah. Well, yeah. They live in an apartment, but yeah.
Yeah.
She ain't going anywhere.
I got the dog, right?
You get the dog. You get the dog and you get some of that money, honey. Aaron Berg, thanks for coming in, buddy.
Dude, thanks for having me. What a day.
Yeah, a lot of fun. Great day. Man. A lot of fun. I mean, I miss Big J. I was very excited, but
and me too. I was hoping your flight was delayed.
Oh, you didn't want me?
Yeah, I was hoping he was.
Oh, gone. You know what? Join the fucking club.
Come on, you did great. There was a tweet that said you proved your worth as a solo host today, and that you don't need anybody else on the show with you.
Oh, not Dan pulled it off in the ninth. Not Dan came in and it's out of the pocket. Not Dan. Bobby. Thank you, everybody. Crackle. I love all you guys. I actually, a lot of, it's so fun too to do shows now and have Bonfire fans.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because you can tell. Bonfire, crackle at the end of the show. If I mention something from the show, like I have that new joke where I got stabbed and people, they're like fucking, oh, because they know the story. Because yeah. I came in here when I was good. But Skank fans too. I mentioned something about Skanks and they start giving the Skank symbol. It's weird.
I love that.
I have all different fan bases that go to the show.
Yeah.
The best fans in the world too, by the way.
Yeah.
The best. Where are you this weekend, dude?
Dude, the city. I'm done with the road for a bit. I'm staying home doing Street Famous during the week and then just doing city spots like crazy.
Dude, I just did a... You know what I'm doing lately? I did it last week in Chicago. I did a pop-up show. This week, I did one at the Comedy Dojo.
Yeah.
I was like, just throw me in Saturday night. Sold it out. Boom. Like that. We added a second show. Comedy Dojo. This Saturday night, last show, and then I go Sunday, New Hampshire for the summer.
Comedy Dojo's a nice place. Is Mike Romanelli's fantastic. You did it.
I've never done it.
Tiff's, and they got the ribs are like some of the best ribs you'll ever eat.
Here we go with the fucking food. These old Jewish comics.
And I'll tell you this. I'll tell you why Voss loves Planet. You eat once there. Mike will wrap you up another meal and take home.
Yeah, I don't want another meal.
You should.
I have a full kitchen with cabinets and a fridge and a wife.
That's nice. Sometimes you leave the ribs in the truck. They stink the truck up. It's nice.
I'm not taking food home from a fucking comedy club.
I take food home all the time.
I'm not.
Everywhere I go after Voss has been there, they go, you don't want something to go like Voss had? Voss will eat him a whole meal there and then ask for one to go.
I tell you,
I love it.
When we did the Creeps with Kids tour, we had catering.
Yeah.
Beautiful Deb would do catering. I mean, tons of food. He would take it all home.
Yeah.
One day I came off stage because I had to close the fucking thing.
Yeah.
He had the food in his duffel bag already.
Yeah.
And I was like, can I have some chicken, please? And he took a whole chicken out of his bag. Oh, I didn't know you were, I thought you were done.
Yeah, you want to eat when you get off stage.
Yeah, I want to eat when I get off stage, something.
Tiff's is great. New Hampshire, I've never been to.
New Hampshire, why don't you come up this summer?
It's the Don't Tread on Me state.
It's the Don't Tread on Me state, and now it's legal to get a gun, baby.
It's legal.
It seems like a place that would have always been legal.
No, but now you can carry a pistol.
Oh, they were treading on them before.
A little bit.
Now they stopped treading on them.
They stopped treading. Yeah. Live free or die, motherfuckers. I feel bad because their logo was the old man on the mountain, and it fell off.
Yeah.
All these people have a stupid license plate with something that doesn't exist anymore.
That Don't Tread on Me flag's a real ugly flag. The yellow flag with the snake. You see that in the neighborhood. You're like, I respect it, but I don't need to live here.
God bless America, man.
Yeah.
God bless America. And God bless all you truckers driving right now.
Yeah.
Getting our goods across the country. Toot, toot. Toot, toot.
There's a Don't Tread on Me gay flag as well.
Oh, that's made up. Don't do that. Don't. Somebody just drove off the phone. God damn it!
You treading on me with your gayness.
There's nothing better than a conservative gay guy. I love that.
Conservative black people are the best.
They're awesome.
So good.
You know, let's just say conservatives are awesome.
Yeah, conservatives are the best. This show's taking a big turn.
It's taking, I know.
Yeah. I mean, no, not really, but just like if you want like family values and people you could trust your kids around, then conservatives.
I mean, stop it.
Yeah,
stop it. There's a bunch of liberals. You know who's jacked and I love?
Who?
JFK Jr.
Yeah, you like him.
Yeah, man. You see how hot he is?
You do a lot of push-ups.
Dude, he is the... I mean, this guy's jacked.
How many push-ups can he do?
Not JFK.
RFK.
RFK Jr., sorry.
JFK Jr.
He's dead.
He's dead for a long time.
Well, not according to Q.
He's like those sub people.
Yeah. Yeah, he's not doing well. RFK, people like him.
Yeah.
But he's got a little thing. He smokes a lot of cigars.
Yeah, he's as jacked as Jacob. You ever see Jacob shirtless?
Come on. Oh, yeah, you can tell, Bobby. You're going to have a face like that soon, too.
I hope so. A nice Kennedy head.
Oh, Kennedy
head. I'll
take it.
Yeah. You see him with his shirt off, pumping iron.
You ever get some Kennedy head? Schwarzenegger used to get Kennedy head.
Documentary on Netflix. Check it out.
It's amazing. Believe me.
It's really good.
Day it came out.
You ever see his Mexican son?
Yeah.
It looks like him.
Looks just like him.
It's a hard... How does that kid walk around? You know, hey, I'd like you to meet my son. Arnold, can I talk to you for a second? What is up?
Vamos to the chopper. Vamos to the chopper.
Aaron Berg, he's got his new show. It is right now. You get it on Patreon.
Yeah.
Street Famous NYC. You are out on the street with a microphone asking the tough questions.
It's crazy. It's all just...
Did you ever get beat up?
No, not yet.
Threatened?
No, I got a great co-host, Andre Myrie. Big black dude, very funny guy.
Yeah,
he comes. It levels it out somehow.
Yeah.
I don't know how, but there's something that people get less offended sometimes knowing that you got a big black friend. But then you'll have people that get offended by him.
You know why that people don't people levels it out? Because he's a big black guy.
Yeah,
yeah. People, I'm gonna fuck with you.
You think it's because of morality or because physical intimidation?
I think both.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. It's cool to have a funny black.
I used to have one.
Did you?
Yeah, I used to have two, and they both, one had a stroke and died, the other one still had a stroke, so I don't have any left.
Man, you're making people stroke.
Sucks.
I'm sorry about that.
I wish they were still around.
Yeah.
Anyways, Big J, go to BigJComedy.com. He is everywhere, all summer long, Fully Loaded Tour, the Skanks Tour, and he's going to be everywhere. And go check me out this Saturday night. I got one show. First show sold out. Second show, tickets still available. Comedy Dojo in New Jersey. And I'm going to be all over the summer doing a little theater tour. I already sold at one of the Seaport, I think, in Portsmouth or whatever. Tickets are selling out. So go to RobertKellyLive.com. Come see me this summer. You guys are the best. Tomorrow we're back. Big J's back. We are back with the Bonfire. We got great guests coming on. Jacob's in Florida. He's coming back next week, but we're not here. I mean, we're pulling this off, baby. We'll see you guys tomorrow on the Bonfire. Hope you enjoyed the show.
Awesome.
Take care. Bye-bye.